everybody. Big warm welcome from me, Carol here at Oak House Journals. Thank you for joining me today. As always, I'm pleased to have you with me. I'm on part three of this little mini-series that I'm doing on origami letters or origami self-locking letters. Bit of a mouthful, that one. There are loads of videos on YouTube about origami or showing origami envelopes and origami letters, and I know that there are also loads in origami books. So this little mini series is really just showing you a few that I personally have used over the years and like to use in my journals, basically because they are so easy. This little one is slightly more dimensional than the ones I showed you in part one and two. So you need to bear that in mind when you're choosing your paper to make this one. Now, this is one that I've made in just normal copier paper, and I would say that that would be perfect for inclusion in a journal. It's not too thick at all. If you wanted to, say, use vintage book page, that tends to be thinner, and that would be good to use. This one I've made with parchment paper, and whilst I would use it in a journal, it is a little bit thicker than I necessarily would like. And so you've got to bear that in mind when you're thinking about the bulk in your journal. Now, as always, you can just pop these in your journal as they are, as journaling spots, and tuck that into a pocket. Or you might want to present a piece of vintage ledger paper or a vintage book page in a nicer way than just folding it, and just include it as an origami folded letter like this. As always, depending on how you use them in your journals, you can create additional tuck spots and pockets. So, for example, if you glue the back down here, then you can just open it up and you've got your journaling spot. If you glue down three sides, then obviously you can use it as a pocket. Now, I know that this is old hat to most of you, but I'm just mentioning it in case you're a newbie out there or something and this is all new to you. So, of course, you can use it as a top pocket like that. You could glue it differently and use it as a side one. The reason I like this little configuration for an origami letter is that you have a little flap here that you can also use as a little pocket. So let's get on and make this little envelope or this little letter. If I open it up, I can show you it's really easy. Less than 10 folds. I think there's about 8 folds in this. And all I've used here is a piece of copier paper that is half A4 size. So I'm not quite sure what that equates to. I think it's about, 15 centimetres by, I think it's about 20. This one's 21. So all I'm going to do is, I'm not going to use this parchment paper. I've got a piece of copier paper off to one side, and all I'm doing is folding it in half along the long edge. And I'm just going to get out my guillotine, and I'm just going to take a small sliver off that center crease to get my piece of paper that I'm going to work with. Now, the first thing we do for this is put it in this orientation, which is a landscape orientation, and you want to find your center point at the top here. Now, you can measure it, but all I'm going to do is just fold my piece of paper over, and then I'm just going to pinch it at the top, like so. And now I know that that is my center point. And what you do then is you just take this top left hand corner and you fold it down from the center point up here, like so. And then you take the other side, the top left hand corner, and fold that side down as well. So you have created a point at the place where you did your pinch mark, like so, and your two pieces meet down the centre. Couldn't be easier, could it? Right, what we're going to do now is we're going to fold this bottom edge up to this edge up here. So just take a piece of paper and fold it up like so. Okay, and now we're just going to fold it up again like so. Alright, so what you have is two folds at the bottom there coming up, and you have something resembling that. Okay, so what we want to do now is we want to take this edge and we want to fold it to the center point. Now the center point along this bottom edge here is easy enough to find, is just straight down from that center point. So it's about there. So I'm just putting my finger that down there, and I'm just going to bring that piece across like so. And make my crease. And I'm going to do the same with this side, bring it in to meet this edge here at the center point. So I'm just going to bend that in like so, put my finger on it, ease that corner out, and I'm just burnishing my creases. Okay, nice and easy. So what we want to do now is we want to bring this point up here down to this point down there. Now when you do that fold, your crease line should automatically go across from these two points here and here. Now what I like to do when I'm doing this fold is I just like to put my ruler on those two points and then just lift up my piece of paper or my point and just bring it over my ruler and start off my crease. And then just take it down to the bottom and burnish my folds. So that's what you've got now. And that's how it looks inside if I just open it up slightly. So I'm just closing that back down again. Now what you want to do, if you just open up this flap again, just open one up, you can see that this top triangle that you've just folded down meets the strip along the bottom here at that point. Okay, if I hold that up to the camera, so this top triangle here meets this strip here at that point. So what you want to do now is you want to make a crease from this point to that point, but obviously when that's across there you can't actually see. So there are a couple of ways to do this. You can put your bone folder there and just hold up your paper until you can actually see that point, or you can put a pencil mark on your flap here and crease this portion so that it lines up with that, or you can just wing it. Now when you've done this several times you can wing it and it's not hard. I tend to like to just put my bone folder on that corner, just lift this portion up until I can see it, and then squeeze that crease into place like so. Okay, so you've done it on one side, so you now need to do it on the other side. So what I suggest you do is you just tuck that one underneath like so and do the same with your preferred method on the other side. So I'm just going to look to see where that join is, and it's there, and then I'm just going to make my crease like so. And that's it, everybody. That is literally it. These two pieces, these pieces that you've just folded up, they stay where they are, but this flap comes down and over the top of them, And then it tucks into this portion here. It tucks into that bit. So you just need to curl it a little bit and tuck it in, like so. And if you've made these creases right, you should get a nice easy tuck there. Now, as you can see on this one, I've made a perfect crease. This one, I've moved it a little bit too far. So that's easy to correct. You just lift up your piece of paper, just move it fractionally and refold it. And tuck this piece back down and in. And I have a much neater finished tuck in this place here. So there we have it, everybody. I hope you like me showing you that one. Super easy, as they all are. I have one more to show you. It's more of a vintage style self-locking letter. It's not an origami one as such. It's one I came up with after looking at some historical letters, and I thought I would give it a try. I do like including this one in some of my journals, although it is a little bit more complicated, but I still hope you'll tune in and take a look and actually give it a try. So look forward to seeing you in part four and the final part of this little mini series. Thanks so much, everybody. Take care. Bye-bye.